In the name of the true and living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, Amen. Although today is the feast of the presentation, it's vaccination that's on everybody's minds. Have you gotten yours yet? Both shots or just the first so far? Are you in a prioritized category? Have you signed up yet online? And if so, will that make any difference to when you actually get the vaccine? Have you started to make any plans for life after the vaccine, like travel plans, for instance? How long do we have to wait before we can do that? If only we could celebrate the vaccination of Jesus rather than the presentation of Jesus, somehow that might make us feel as though everything was getting better. Recently, a friend shared with me images of the murals by the Mexican artist Diego Rivera in the Detroit Institute of Arts, which I had never seen before. Maybe some of you far more arty people than I have seen these before. I'd certainly never laid eyes on the most controversial section of the 27 panels of the incredible installation of 20th century art, which is the panel known as The Vaccination. To any and all, that panel there in the Detroit Institute of Arts looks like a modern version of a nativity scene, presented in the curvy but boxy crayon-colored style of Diego Rivera. In the center, a golden-haired child, painted with that odd combination of glockiness and roundness. On one side of him, a nurse, his mother, and she's holding him in his swaddling clothes. On the other side is a doctor, maybe Joseph, firmly holding the child's left arm while he carefully sticks a needle into fleshy baby biceps. In the background are three men. Let's assume they are wise men. They are scientists dressed in lab coats and hunched over a microscope. In the foreground are animals, a horse or a donkey, an ox or a cow, and three sheep or rams. As an image for our times, when anti-vaxxers have been confronted by the real and necessary promise of vaccines that do more than just save lives, they also restore a crippled society, this marvelous image, this painting by Diego Rivera, with all its religious overtones, is just stunning. I've asked Mark to put an image of it up online for those of you who are watching online, and those of you who aren't, it'll be up on the web later on. Or maybe you've already seen them and can call an image the image to mind. When it was completed in 1933, during the depths of the Great Depression, the whole monumental work in the garden court of the DIA caused a great stir. But this one panel, Vaccination, was the subject of the most pointed and urgent criticism. Various Roman Catholic groups took aim at its composition and imagery. And the Detroit News reported that the Reverend H. Ralph Higgins, senior curate of St. Paul's Episcopal Cathedral, objects particularly to the so-called vaccination panel. In quotes, "The painting should be washed from the walls because it inevitably must impress the spectator as a satire of that family dear to religions," Mr. Higgins said. On the Sunday after the murals were first opened for public viewing in March of 1933, more than 10,000 people went to see them. I'm guessing that's more than went to hear Mr. Higgins preach on that Sunday morning. Now, Diego Rivera was a notorious atheist and worse, a socialist. He called religion a form of collective neurosis. One of his famous murals includes an inscription that reads, "Dios no existe," God does not exist. And he once quipped that I've never believed in God, but I believe in Picasso, firmly establishing his atheist credentials. In fact, though, according to the New York Times, Rivera denied that the panel Vaccination was intended to caricature the Holy Family. On the contrary, he said, he had rather tried to sanctify science as contributing to the saving of life. But the story of this particular mural gets even better. Good authority has it that the face of the baby, the golden-haired Christ child in the center of the painting, the face of this baby was modeled on the Lindbergh baby, the news of whose kidnap and murder had been in all the papers throughout the entire time that Rivera and his team were painting the murals. Dig a little deeper and you'll find also on good authority that the face of the nurse mother, Mary, was inspired by Jean Harlow. The doctor Father Joseph was modeled on the museum's director, and that the three scientists slash wise men, each with a distinctive flesh tone and hair color, are supposed to be, quite intentionally, a Catholic, a Protestant, and a Jew. Boringly, the animals, which to me surely look like references to the stable residents in Bethlehem, are said to represent creatures from whom was supplied serum for the production of the vaccines. Now, Rivera's atheism is said to have stemmed from his objection to the vicious effect of the Roman Catholic Church on the indigenous peoples and cultures of Mexico, when the church came arm and arm with the conquistadors. And also, from his reflection on an explanation given to him when he was 5 years old as to why his twin brother had died at the age of 2. The explanation being something along the lines of God needed another angel. On the basis of which Rivera lost his faith. I suppose that Rivera could not have foreseen a progressive church for which the image of the vaccination of the baby Jesus could represent a beautiful confluence of the life-saving work of science and Savior, without any need to insist that their spheres of interest, inquiry, or influence are separate from one another. In the epistle reading from Hebrews assigned for today, the writer says, since God's children share flesh and blood, Jesus himself likewise shared the same things, so that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death. This notion that God became like us, flesh and blood and all, through the sending of his Son, in order to save us, undergirds a great deal of Christian theology. It's trying to make sense of why God acted in this way, why God chose to express his love in this way, why God used the soft power of incarnation rather than deploy armies from heaven to save us from the power of death and the devil. Diego Rivera may not have believed any of that, but in some way he clearly understood it. And his vaccination mural is a stunning depiction of the incarnation, whether he wanted it to be or not. The juxtaposition of the incarnate Savior, endowed with the face of a kidnapped and murdered child, receiving the gift of vaccination, is what you might call inspired. You can almost imagine, I can, an elderly couple down on their luck in 1933, both unemployed, hungry, maybe out of hope, going to the Detroit Institute of the Arts on a Sunday morning or afternoon in March, since they had nothing else to do, no work to go to. And a couple like that was not very likely to darken the door of Reverend Mr. Higgins Cathedral. I can see them standing there in the garden court and taking in the color of that immense room of art on all four sides of them, with their heads tilted back, craning their necks up as they took in the murals of Detroit industry. The couple is old and tired and poor. If ever they had imagined that God had made any promises to them, they'd long ago concluded that God had reneged on those promises. And standing before the north wall, they look up and to the right, in the corner where a panel of smaller scale than the rest of that immense work all around them shows a scene that at once seems so modern and so ancient, so weird and so deeply, deeply familiar to them at the same time. It's a child who looks disturbingly familiar to them, being given a vaccine. Are those his parents, or a doctor and a nurse? And who are those three men behind them? But doesn't the whole thing just look like hope? Doesn't the whole thing just look like life? Doesn't the whole thing just look like love? Doesn't the whole thing look to them like promises that they'd given up on, maybe never dared hope in the first place? And aren't their words now echoing in their hearts, summoned by the Spirit, of those two old folks whose lives are coming to a close in a world where there was not much hope left for them? Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.